Hello dear students, welcome back to our general physics class. Our lesson for today is about Newton's second law of motion. At the end of this lesson, you are expected to apply Newton's second law in kinematics to obtain quantitative and qualitative conclusions about the velocity and acceleration of one or more bodies, and the contact and non-contact forces acting on one or more bodies. Solve problems using Newton's laws of motion in contexts such as, but not limited to, ropes and pulleys, the design of mobile sculptures, transport of loads on conveyor belts, force needed to move stalled vehicles, determination of safe driving speeds on banked curved roads. Let's have a quick review. Fill in the blanks with the right words that will make the statement true from the word pool below. Newton's first law says that an object that is not moving or is at rest will stay at rest, and an object that is moving will keep moving with constant velocity, which means at the same speed and in the same direction, unless an outside force acts on that object. Proceeding with our lesson, we all know that the second law of motion states that the acceleration of an object as produced by a net force is directly proportional to the magnitude of the net force, in the same direction as the net force, and inversely proportional to the mass of the object. As an equation, it is expressed as A equals net force over mass. Rearranging our equation, the net force is equated to the product of the mass times the acceleration. For the first application of Newton's second law of motion, let us have free fall with air resistance. In the diagrams below, free body diagram showing the forces acting upon an 85 kg skydiver, equipment included, are shown. For each case, use the diagrams to determine the net force and acceleration of the skydiver at each instant in time. For diagram A, we know that the net force is just the same with our force of gravity, so we have net force equals to 833 newtons. To find the acceleration, we will use the second law of motion, so we write A equals net force over m. Substituting our given values, we get acceleration as 9.8 meters per square second. For diagram B, given an air resistance, we need to form an equation to find the net force. So we write, net force is equals to the force of gravity minus air resistance force. Take note that since we are in free fall motion, all downward objects are given a positive sign, while the air resistance force is given a negative sign because it opposes gravity and is directed upwards. Now solving for net force, we get 483 newtons by deducting 350 newton of air resistance force from our 833 gravity force. Now to solve for acceleration, we substitute our given mass and obtained net force value and get an acceleration of 5.68 meters per square second. Notice how the air resistance decreased the acceleration of our diver from 9.8 to 5.68. Let's continue. For diagram C, the air resistance force has increased to 700, giving a total net force of 133 newtons. The acceleration of the diver in this situation has now decreased to 1.56 meters per square second, a lot slower than the acceleration of diagram B. For diagram D, the air resistance force equaled the magnitude of the gravity force, resulting to a net force of 0 newtons. In this case, the acceleration of the diver becomes 0 meters per second, which means the diver is now falling with a constant velocity. The application of Newton's second law of motion is not limited to a single body dynamics. In this portion of our lesson, we are now going to study about the application of Newton's laws to multibody dynamics. For example number 1, we have a 5 kg and a 10 kg box are touching each other. A 45 newtons horizontal force is applied to the 5 kg box in order to accelerate both boxes across the floor. Ignore friction forces and determine the acceleration of the boxes and the force acting between the boxes. Since we are looking for the acceleration, we will be solving this problem using a system analysis. A system analysis is usually performed to determine the acceleration of the system. It is combined with an individual object analysis. And in the individual object analysis, either one of the two objects is isolated and considered as a separate, independent object. To start drawing our free body diagram, let us replace the child with an arrow representing the applied force. Now to analyze the objects individually, we need to separate the boxes. First, we need to choose which object we want to analyze first. For this, I chose the smaller box first. Now, we need to construct a free body diagram and identify and calculate the individual forces acting upon the object. Starting with the 5 kg box, we are given an applied force of 45 newtons, and thus we draw the diagram like this. For the force of gravity, we can calculate it by getting the weight of the box, W is equals to mass times gravity, so we get 49 newtons. For the normal force, we just copy the magnitude of the force of the gravity since they are balanced. The contact force is a force that acts at the point of contact between two objects, in contrast to body forces. Also defined as the force in which an object comes in contact with another object. To determine the direction of the contact force, we only need to look at the direction of the applied force and oppose it. In this case, since the applied force is directed to the right, the contact force that will be exerted by the bigger box to the smaller box will be directed leftward. Now to analyze the 10 kg box, we draw the first two forces, normal force and force of gravity, and calculate their value. Now for the contact force, we draw it directed rightward since it is the direction that our smaller object will make contact with our bigger object. Since we have now completed the free body diagrams for our two boxes, we can now proceed to solving the problem. Observing our diagrams, we can see that we have known values for the applied force, normal forces, and gravity force, but the contact force is unknown. Now how do we find the acceleration, which is what is asked? Simple. We just need to use the second law of motion. Forming our first equation from the smaller box, we know that our vertical forces will cancel because of equal magnitude, so we will only be considering our horizontal forces. To calculate the net force, we write 45 newtons, which is the applied force, minus the contact force opposing it, equals to our 5 kg mass, and the acceleration. For equation 2, notice that the vertical forces are again balanced, thus it has zero net force, while our horizontal force is composed of just the contact force. Thus, we write, contact force equals the 10 kg mass times the acceleration. Substituting equation 2 to equation 1, we get 45 newtons minus 10 kg times acceleration as equals to 5 kg times acceleration. You can already shift solve this part of the equation or continue with the algebra as shown. 45 newtons is equals to 10 ey plus 5 ey. 45 newtons is equals to 15 ey. And finally, we get an acceleration of 3 meters per square second. Now let us solve for the contact force. Substituting the acceleration to equation 2, we get contact force equals to 30 newtons. Example 2. A 5.0 kilograms and a 10.0 kilograms box are touching each other. A 45.0-n horizontal force is applied to the 5.0 kilograms box in order to accelerate both boxes across the floor. The coefficient of kinetic friction is 0.200. Determine the acceleration and the contact force. In this case, we are now going to consider friction force because we are given the coefficient of kinetic friction of 0.2. To analyze the system, let us draw our free body diagrams. Since the values are not changed, we can draw our diagrams similar to our first example. Only in this case, we don't need to analyze our system individually. We are going to consider our system as a whole, just like this. Notice that since we are going to consider it as a single system, the normal forces and the gravity forces are combined. Next, we draw our friction force. Notice that the arrow representing our friction force is smaller than the applied force. This is because our system must accelerate. and equal magnitude forces are only applicable to stationary objects. To calculate the friction, we write the formula, friction force is equals to coefficient of kinetic friction or μK, times the normal force. Substituting the values, we get friction force equals to 29.4 newtons. To calculate acceleration, we will use the second law of motion equation, net force equals mass times acceleration. For the net force, the vertical forces have a net force of 0 newtons, while the horizontal forces have 45 newtons applied force, and a 29.4 newton friction force. Substituting the values, we get an acceleration of 1.04 meters per square second by dividing both sides of the equation with 15 kilograms. Lastly, we will be determining the friction force affecting our 10 kilogram box. To calculate, we write friction as equals to coefficient of kinetic friction times the normal force. Substituting our values, we get 19.6 newtons friction force. To solve for the contact force, we use the second law of motion equation, net force equals mass times acceleration. Our horizontal net force is equals to contact force minus the friction force, equals to mass time acceleration. Substituting the friction force 19.6 newtons, 10 kilogram mass, and 1.04 meters per square second acceleration, we get contact force equals to 30 newtons. Looking closely, we can now confidently say that our free body diagram is correct. The friction force is really smaller than the contact force and the applied force. That ends our lesson for today. Have a nice day.